डिस्कस अबाउट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ टॉन्ग. ओके, सो टॉन्ग अपियर्स इन एम्ब्रायो ऑफ अप्रोक्सीमेटली 4 वीक्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ 2 लैटरल लिंगुअल स्वेलिंग्स, 2 लैटरल लिंगुअल स्वेलिंग्स एंड 1 मेडियल स्वेलिंग, दैट इज ट्यूबरकुलम इम्पार, दैट इज कॉल्ड ट्यूबरकुलम इम्पार. सो इट डिवलप्स फ्रॉम 2 लैटरल स्वेलिंग एंड 1 मेडियल स्वेलिंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड ट्यूबरकुलम इम्पार. ओके, सो लेट मी ड्रॉ द फेरेंजियल आर्च. आई एम ड्रॉइंग ऑन दिस साइड. ओके, सो दीज आर फेरेंजियल आर्च. ओके, सिमिलरली ऑन अदर साइड. ओके, सो दिस इज लैटरल स्वेलिंग. This arises from first arch, okay, lateral swelling, and this is another lateral swelling, and there and this two meets, and in the middle there is tuberculum impar. Okay, so this is first arch. So these swellings arise from first arch. Okay, and these 3 swellings originate from first pharyngeal arch. A second median swelling, the copula or hypobrachial eminence, is formed by मेजोडर्म ऑफ द सेकेंड, थर्ड एंड फोर्थ आर्च. ओके, सो लेट्स राइट. ओके, लेट मी राइट इट. सेकेंड मीडियन स्वेलिंग कोपुला, कोपुला और ऑल्सो कॉल्ड हाइपोब्रैकियल इमिनेंस, हाइपोब्रैकियल इमिनेंस. हाइपोब्रैकियल मीन्स इट इज अंडर दिस स्वेलिंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड हाइपोब्रैकियल इमिनेंस. इमिनेंस मीन्स स्वेलिंग. ओके, so this is formed by mesoderm of the second, third and part of the fourth arch. Okay, so here are also swellings. Okay, so these swellings contributes to development of tongue, and in the middle there it is called cupula or also called hypobrachial eminence. Okay, immediately behind this swelling is the laryngeal orifice, which is flanked by the arytenoid cartilage. Okay, so let me draw it. The, let's say this is fourth, this is 1, 2, 3 and 4th. Okay, so immediately behind this there is laryngeal orifice. Okay, laryngeal orifice, there it is orifice, and this is flanked by arytenoid swellings. So on these both sides there are arytenoid swellings. Okay, and we later see its development. Okay, so immediately behind this swelling is laryngeal orifice, which is flanked by the arytenoid swelling. As the lateral swellings increase in size, they overgrow the tuberculum impar and merge, forming anterior two-third or body of tongue. Okay, so these merge and form these lateral swellings and tuberculum impar merge and form the anterior two-third or body of tongue. Okay, because the mucosa covering the body of tongue originates from first pharyngeal arch, sensory innervation to this area is by the mandibular branch of trigeminal nerve. Okay, the body of tongue is separated from the posterior third by a V-shaped groove that is called terminal sulcus. Okay, so let me draw it for you. There is, let's say this is, here it is terminal sulcus. Okay, so terminal sulcus. Okay, so this is V-shaped. Okay, and this separates it from posterior part. Okay, this is contributed by first arch and these are posterior arch. Okay, so posterior, I mean to say that in second, third, fourth arch, this contributes to posterior part of tongue. Okay, so the body of tongue is separated from posterior third by a V-shaped groove, the terminal sulcus. The posterior part or root of tongue originates from second, third and parts of the fourth pharyngeal arch. Okay, the fact that sensory innervation to this part of tongue is supplied by glossopharyngeal nerve indicates that tissue of the third arch overgrows that of the second. So you know the posterior third of tongue is supplied by glossopharyngeal nerve. Okay, so the fact that the sensory innervation to this part of the tongue is supplied by glossopharyngeal nerve indicates that tissue of third arch overgrows that of the second. The epiglottis and the extreme posterior part of the tongue are innervated by superior laryngeal nerve, reflecting their development from fourth arch. So let me write it: epiglottis and extreme posterior part of tongue. Extreme posterior part of tongue. Extreme posterior part of tongue. These are innervated by superior laryngeal nerve. So what those indicates? This indicates the development of the epiglottis and extreme posterior part of tongue from fourth arch. Because you know what is the nerve of fourth arch? Nerve of fourth arch is superior laryngeal nerve. Okay. Some of the tongue muscles probably differentiate in situ, but most are derived from myoblast originating in the occipital somites. Thus, tongue musculature is innervated by hypoglossal nerve. Okay. So this makes sense. Okay. The general sensory innervation of the tongue is easy to understand. The body is supplied by trigeminal nerve. The body is supplied by trigeminal nerve. The nerve of first arch. That of root is supplied by glossopharyngeal nerve and vagus nerve. The nerve of the third and fourth arch. Okay, this is nerve of third arch and this is nerve of fourth arch. A special sensory innervation to the anterior two-thirds of the tongue is provided by chorda tympani, branch of facial nerve, whereas posterior third is supplied by glossopharyngeal nerve. Okay.